The foundations of Poe Performance began as a strength training facility for athletes. I began that endeavor because I was tired of seeing athletes not perform to a certain level, thus the name Poe Performance, but secondarily, and even more importantly, too many preventable injuries. One of the preventative exercises that we would do at Poe Performance was grip strength. Grip strength matters in sport. Now, while some, it's going to help more than others, it will never hurt you. Grip strength is never a disabler. It's never a hindrance. It's always an enabler. In real life, if you've ever been in a situation where someone with really good grip strength shakes your hand, or maybe you're wrestling or grappling a little bit, I know when I trained Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, I found out real quick who the guys were that have grappled for a long time. Their paws, they just felt like they could yank your arm out of the socket, and some probably could. And so it really was an eye-opener for me to realize how important grip strength was, not just in sport, but in real life. And that's long before I started shooting pistols, more regularly anyway. So I ended up, when I got into the gun situation and shooting, I started realizing when I started applying the fundamentals, and some of my older videos are awful. My technique was so bad, but I kept working on it. There's a local law enforcement officer who's a SWAT team member, and I've worked on it even as recently last year, and he was making minor tweaks to my hand position and trying to help me. And I'm always looking to improve. And so as when I first started shooting, though, the one thing that kept coming to my mind was, if I put this gun out here, what's helping me, even though my technique was poor to start and the ergonomics fit me, was my grip strength. I have decent grip strength. Probably above anything else in the gym, where I'm very average at everything else, grip strength I'm above average in, and I'm really thankful for that. It has helped me in my pistol shooting. I've received compliments on my videos about how flat the gun shoots, and you must be a real good shooter, and I'm not a great shooter, but my grip strength is good. So that helps kind of offset other areas that I'm lacking in. So when we think about the three components of shooting a pistol and controlling snappiness, and I just want to annihilate that word. I'm going to talk more in a minute why, but I just don't like it. It's so overused in the gun community. But anyway, the three components to shooting a pistol. Number one, ergonomics. You should settle that when you first buy your gun. I have said before in a video that I knew a guy who bought a gun. He bought a Glock 19 Gen 3. I think it's a good choice, but it didn't fit his hands. His hands were squatty and short, didn't reach the trigger well, it was too big for him. He didn't shoot it well, didn't control it well. He ended up selling it, buying an M&P shield, shoots way better with it. And so the ergonomic factor matters. Don't ever let anybody tell you ergonomics don't matter on a handgun, because it's a lie. Number two, controlling a handgun through proper technique and fundamentals. And part of that is gonna be neural. The more you practice, the neural portion connecting the brain to the hands, and the muscles of the upper back and the arms all the way out to the forearms doing the same thing every time, repetitions are going to matter. They're going to help. Now, some people might live 80 miles away from the closest range, so they can't put 50 rounds down range every single week. Sometimes they can't make it to the range but every couple of months due to life schedule, financial obligations, etc. And I get that. Brings me to the third component, grip strength. You have no excuse to have weak hands. None, especially a healthy adult male, zero, no excuse. And in just a little bit, we're gonna head out to my gym. Just recently, my wife filmed me doing some grip exercises. There's some of my favorites, there are way more. These are just a handful of some of my favorites that have worked for my athletes over the years and then still work for myself. I still do those, especially as I age. If I ever had to fight for my life, I want my hands to be strong, to be able to push someone away or pull them close, whatever is appropriate for the situation, as well as control my handgun better and put follow-up shots on target. Also, if somebody were to grab my gun and it's in my hands, I want to make sure that my hands are strong enough to be able to retain that weapon and not let it get into the hands of someone who potentially would want to kill me or my family. So grip strength, out of the three, you can't control genetics and how big you are. Plus, I've seen smaller guys with good technique and good grip strength shoot a gun really well. So size of the person can matter. Does it always? No. But out of the three variables, ergonomics of the handgun, that's on you when you buy one. Number two is a technique. That's going to come through repetition. of live fire. Number three is going to be grip strength. No excuse to have weak grip. So let's head out to the gym and take a look at a few of my favorite exercises that will help you guys control your handgun better. But before you go out, keep in mind, this is not built for acoustics. This is a gym. So please no comments on the echo, because I've taped in there before and it is a little echoey at times. So just a heads up for you guys, it's a gym, not a studio. Take a look at these exercises. So one of the most affordable grip tools to hold onto your pistol better are going to be the spring grippers. And you can buy these at any sporting goods store, Kmart, Walmart, and they've been around for years. They come in different configurations. They have foam on them, and they've also got them in plastic like these. And when you do these, try not to cheat and do a short stroke on it. Try to take it all the way down and get the full range of motion on the grip and work the fingers, the hands, and the forearms. One way that I like to do them is in between major lifts. So say you're doing an overhead press or a row or a bench press, grab the grippers in between and hit a set of maybe 25 reps and then hold on to them for 25 seconds. That's a really good active recovery tool to do in between your major lifts. So no excuse to not have these. They're cheap and they're readily available. So another relatively inexpensive tool to use for your grip is the fat grips. FATGRIPZ. You can pick these up on Elite Fitness. I believe Amazon has them now, and eBay as well. And they do exactly what their name says, which is make the grip fatter. So if you have a dumbbell, you place them on a dumbbell and you do dumbbell rows or curls or presses. You can also use them on a barbell as well. Another way to utilize these is to do farmer's walks, weighted carries with them. So you'd use a heavier dumbbell and fat grips, and you can walk for distance or for time. And at the same time, you're working your posture, upper back, rear delts. You're also working your grip and getting a good cardio workout at the same time. So check out fat grips. Great tool to hang onto that pistol. Moving along to dumbbells. And even if you don't have a massive gym at home or one with a lot of equipment, a lot of people have got dumbbell sets. And a really simple one is if you take a hex dumbbell, you grip it over the end, and you just hold it for time. And you can do this until your grip fails, or you can do it for time and then work sets with it. I do recommend you do this on your knees, because if you do it to failure and a dumbbell falls, it's gonna hurt your feet. So it's really a good idea to do this on your knees to avoid any foot injuries. So that's a really good one, very simple one to do with a dumbbell. So a very simple but effective grip exercise is a plate pinch. And what you're going to do is take the worded side that's kind of indented, smooth side out on both sides, and you're just going to grip it. And you can do this one on your knees as well, just like the dumbbell. And you would put one on each side and hold those for time or until failure. That's a really good one as well. Now another one is an advanced version of the plate pinch, and these are a little bit heavier. These are 225-pound plates, and the way this one works is you can grab with both hands and you can hold, or you can rotate. This one you feel from the upper back all the way into the fingers. Plate pinches, two different varieties, both are awesome. So there are several exercises that are going to help you guys with your grip to help control the snappiness of a handgun. Now I'm going to touch on the word snappy and why I want to eliminate it from the gun community vocabulary. In World War II, there were kids that lied about their age. There were 16, 17-year-old kids who stormed the beaches of Normandy. Do you think they were concerned that their rifles were loaded a beast of a cartridge in a .30-06? You think the 45 ACP scared them? They were getting ready to storm beaches where they possibly could die. That was their focus. So think about in a life or death situation, if you were to have to pull your pistol, you're not gonna pull that and go, this is a 40 Smith & Wesson, I can't control this thing. No, you're gonna revert to the level of training you have, which I hope is adequate, and hopefully you're gonna put rounds where they need to be, all right? Now the components again, ergonomics, you can help that. How much you practice, that's on you. That's going to be very individual. Number three, grip strength. So that in a real life situation, you grip that handgun nice and tight so nobody can take it, and you put rounds where they need to be. So, in closing, Newton's second law of momentum talks about an object in motion is going to be changed. How much it's changed is going to be dependent on the force applied to it, basically. So that object's going to stay in motion until some outside force stops it. While we don't want to impede the slide reaction moving back and forth, the reciprocation, the energy that's pushed through the grip of the gun, we definitely want to impede. We don't want that going out of the grip and allowing the gun to flip all over the place. We want to use the big muscles of the upper back and the shoulders, right down through the forearms, the hands, get a good solid technique locked in there, lock those wrists where the recoil is more a push against your whole upper body instead of flipping the muzzle upward, which is very difficult to recover from and put shots where they need to be. So I hope this video helped you guys. Do some of these exercises. Maybe you already do them. Maybe you have some you'd like to share. Put them down below in the comments, please. If you haven't liked and subscribed, please do. I always appreciate your support. Thanks for watching, everybody.